Good afternoon, Indira Shah here. Today, let me show you how to make patra. Patra is, this is called as patra. Patre, this is the patarvel they say in Gujarati. I'm going to show you how to make patra in the Gujarati way. This is Colocasia leaves, chembu elai in Malayalam and Tamil. This actually used to grow, the leaves used to be very big in my garden, but then just a few days before, the rodent, removed the whole thing and destroyed the plant. So now I have only small few leaves. Otherwise, I used to have plenty of leaves and I used to share them to so many. So that's very unfortunate. But anyway, I can show you how to make patra the Gujarati way, okay? So for making patra, you need gram flour, kadle hittu, okay? I've taken only this much because the leaves are very tiny and very less, okay? And then you need tamarind juice. If usually Gujaratis do not use tamarind because they say if you eat tamarind, you get joint pains. That's because of the weather conditions in Gujarat perhaps. If you do not want to use tamarind juice, you can use lime juice, okay? But for me, tamarind, gives a good taste. And then you need jaggery because all Gujarati cookings is not complete without sugar or jaggery. So I'm using jaggery. Then you need little dhania powder, red chili powder, salt, and hing, okay? Now what you should do is, you should make a paste, okay? See, I'm going to add salt, the required salt. And then asafoetida. And then the red chili powder and the dhania powder. And then jaggery. I have sliced the jaggery. And then the tamarind juice. Okay. You can add little water to make a thick paste. Not very thick, like the bhaji, dough here. It shouldn't be very watery, not very thick, because you have to, spread it at the back of the leaves. See, usually the big leaves will have thick veins. So you have to cut the veins here. I have cut it. Usually for a huge leaf, the veins will be very thick. So we have to slice the vein. Here the veins are very small because the leaves are very tender, so I'm not taking it out. Trust me, this Gujarati way of patra will be very, very tasty. We need to steam cook this once we apply, So take the bigger one. Now take the bigger leaf. And then, see, you have to apply it at the back of the leaves and let it be little thick. You can't apply just sparingly. It should be just well applied. Okay? Usually what we do is, if it is bigger one, we do like this, about only 3 or 4 leaves we take. One upon the other, we apply like this and fold. But since this is very small, tiny and tender, all together I'm going to apply like this. One upon the other. Now this I'll fold it, okay? fold and then apply, fold and then apply. Keep it aside. Now you can take another leaf. So you should segregate the leaves, big to small and smallest. I have already segregated. You should always wash this once or twice, because there would be some mud or anything, or manure, anything, any dust particle. So always you have to wash them. Fold it, apply, fold, apply, fold. Okay, now we have to steam cook it. I'll come back here. Since the quantity is very less, I am taking a very small cooker. I have kept enough water. Now I am keeping a plate, and over the plate I am keeping this hold vessel and cover it, and then steam cook for 15 to 20 minutes. So I'll come back to you once this is done. Here, this is 20 minutes over. To check whether it's done, dip your fingers in water and touch it. If it is not sticking, it's done. Okay, now what you should do is you have to cut them into slices here, into thin slices like this, because tampering should be done. Here, for tampering you need oil, about 2 spoons of oil, then mustard seeds, then white till. Okay, now add them slowly. See, the quantity that I am making today is very less because there are no leaves. Okay, now fry it for 2 minutes, and then I'll just put it in a plate and show you. This should be fried for 2 minutes. Here, the Gujarati way of making patra is ready. Trust me, this will be very tasty. I'm really feeling shy because I've just done it in a very small quantity. Usually I do it so much that we eat it for 2 to 3 days. This will be very tasty. I want you to try. But colocasia with a black stem is always better. It will not itch your tongue or throat. But the colocasia leaves or the chamber leaves with a white or green stem always itches, when you eat. So be careful when you do it. This does not itch. That is the reason we add either tamarind pulp or the lemon juice. Okay, so if you have any doubt, please message me. Thank you very much for watching my YouTube channel in the name of Indira Shah. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe and like my channel and like my video, and then please share my YouTube channel with your friends and relatives. And if there are any youngsters at home, the bachelors or spinsters, because I'm coming up with videos specially for them, those who are starters, for them I have come up with videos. Please share it with them. So thank you very much. This is Indira again signing off with Vela. Bye bye.